Today I'm going to talk about something a little bit different, and it's something that many of you maybe didn't even think about. I mean, I didn't think about it for a while, but pinball or pinball machines, whichever way you want to put it, are kind of having a second chance or resurrection or life, as it is, through video games. There's been a long period of time where pinball machines, or just pinball in general, kind of fell to the wayside. For many reasons. It's very expensive to make and maintain these machines. You gotta think about it. I mean, just look at this example you see representation in a game called Pinball FX2. This is a video game pinball machine, which is not based on any real world one, it's an original one, but you can still see how intricate it is. In fact, there's even a tiny little mini pinball table at one point you can get to, which I do pretty bad at. But still, you can see why stuff like this is pretty difficult and expensive to maintain, you know what I mean? I've played on many real pinball machines. I like it a lot. While I don't like pinball as much as video games, and I'm not as good at it, I'm actually better at the real pinball machines than the video game form, by the way, as you see here, but whatever, I haven't played this that long. It's unique in itself, because when you're playing pinball, it's really simplistic, but at the same time can be complex. It's one of those things that's easy to play, hard to master. I'm pretty sure you've heard of that kind of thing. The whole game is around getting score, and all the while you're competing against gravity and the force of the metal ball going down. It's pretty unique in that way, and it's a lot of fun. But in the sad part is that they've kind of fell to the wayside. I mean, think about it. A lot of places where you'd find pinball machines, there's a little pinball table I was talking about, and I do bad at it every time. Most of the time when you find pinball machines, they're in the arcade, and as you know, there aren't many around. I mean, I've said there's at least three I can go to, but still, that's not a lot. They each have pinball machines. Well, one really has more than any of them, the other two combined. But, you know, still, you don't come across these things that often, and like I said, it's because they're very expensive to make and maintain, difficult to maintain. I've mentioned a few times I used to have this class I took optional when I was in school. It was called vending, but there was also arcade machines in there and pinball machines. And I used to talk to my teacher in the old time when there was nothing going on. I was his assistant at one point, and he had his own of the two pinball machines in there. One of them was his own personal one, which I really liked. That one was probably my favorite pinball machine ever. Is Bram Stoker's Dracula, from the, you know, it's based on the movie that came out in, was it 1991? I don't know. It's the one that's got Keanu Reeves and Gary Oldman and Winona Ryder in it. Anyway, and there was also Taxi, based off the TV show. And I was talking, I was like, how difficult is it exactly to fix something when it's wrong with a pinball machine? He says, it's one of the most complicated things you could ever imagine. And he says, just in order to understand that, just look at all the stuff that's in there and how it works and all that kind of stuff. The Bram Stoker's Dracula one, by the way, had this green mist on one part of the field there, to like where the painting is. Like, look on this one here, the painting where their heads would be, it's around there. And there's this magnet that goes underneath, and at one point when you trigger something, it pulls the metal ball along, and you have to use another ball to hit that one. It's pretty difficult, but still. That's a complicated process. The whole thing's very mechanical, and it's very complex. And it's no wonder that they really haven't been, you know, as much as they are. And it's a shame, because they're a lot of fun to play. But getting to the point here, through video games, it's possible now to do things, for one, that you can't pull off in a real pinball machine, and also stuff you can. For example, Zen Studios, is the company that makes this. I used to have Zen Pinball, the first one on the PlayStation Network, which was only on there for a long time. I love that. In fact, I like that more than some of the retail games I had for it, and I played a lot. And you know what one of the reasons was? Is because it had not exactly 100% real physics, although it's probably possible they could do that. It was real enough, and it feels real enough. The ball feels like it has enough weight behind it, which it does here in this one you're seeing. And the physics are realistic enough that it feels like you're playing the real thing. And that's something real good. Even if you're not a huge pinball wizard, as the term is, and you're just someone like me that just likes playing it and not even that great at it, it still goes a long ways of feeling how good it is. It simulates a real pinball machine good enough. And that's what's so awesome about it. Not to mention, you get all these crazy original tables that you can't get in the real ones. I mean, they just came out with this pack. They got a bunch of Star Wars-based ones. And one of them even has a little mini shmup section where you're controlling three different TIE fighters at the same time. It's basically your health. And you need to shoot down a certain amount of X-Wings. That's really cool. It's got all the sounds. It's got lasers, music, and all that from Star Wars. And they got Marvel tables with X-Men and the Hulk and stuff like that. But you see what I mean? You can pull off stuff that you couldn't in real ones. But there are some companies that aren't they're different from this one, that actually do make ones based on the real original ones. I can't remember the name of the company because I haven't really looked into them much, because I'm actually more interested in these kind, the crazy ones. But here's the funny thing, and this is the thing I'll leave it off on. This is actually something new, making video pinball games. There's a couple of famous old ones, like Sonic Spinball. I like that a lot, and I've heard a lot of people say they like that, so it's got kind of weird physics, but it's still fun. Devil's Crush, which is probably one of the best 2D video pinball games. And then if you go really far back on the Atari 2600, there actually is one called Video Pinball. I've actually had it a couple times. I like it a lot. It's simplistic looking, but it's actually really fun. It's weird too, because you can control the ball if you hold the button and then you move it around. I guess that's their way of simulating tilt, but or bumping the table, the pinball table, I mean. But it's awesome, and every now and then you get games that have a little mini-game in it. Hell, Duke Nukem Forever, there's a very basic mini pinball game you can play within the game. I'm just saying. So it's got that kind of stuff too. But I find it interesting that for video games, it's possible to have pinball have a resurgence, and it is right now. Zen Pinball is very popular, considering how it's actually kind of niche at the same time. And there's all these other ones that are doing it. It's a very popular thing for people to play on these iPad things and phones and all that. The screen actually makes sense. It's pretty much the only thing that will work good on a touchscreen. And it's just, it's a lot of fun. And it's a great way to play pinball machines, especially like to quote-unquote own your own, which is very expensive, but you can't. So you get something like this, and you can even buy the tables you want and not the ones you don't. And you can even try each one for a short amount of time to see if you even want to get it. Or if you like pinball. For example, this one here, Pinball FX 2, which is on Steam, even gives you a free table, which is the one I'm playing with. You can play it as much as you want. So you can figure out if you don't even like pinball, if you like it and you want to get into it, or if you like this and you can get more. It's a great way of going about it. So this is a great thing that it's able to preserve pinball in a way. People talk about preserving video games, but this is also another factor. Video games are also able to preserve pinball in a way now. So I find that very interesting. So that's all I wanted to talk about. Say what you think about this and so on and so forth. So thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you later.